Hello viewers, welcome back. And in this tutorial, we are going to discuss the anatomy of scapular region muscles. So there are six muscles of the scapular region, and these muscles connect the scapula to the humerus. And so these muscles are associated with the movements at the shoulder joint. So if we just identify these muscles, so these muscles are the deltoid muscle, the supraspinatus, the infraspinatus, the teres minor, the teres major, and the subscapularis muscle. Four muscles of these six attach to the capsule of the shoulder joint, and so these muscles make up the rotator cuff. So the muscles which make up the rotator cuff are the supraspinatus, infraspinatus, teres minor, and subscapularis muscle. So now we will discuss each of these six scapular region muscles individually. So the deltoid is this superficial muscle of the shoulder. This muscle is responsible for this characteristic rounded outline of the shoulder. The deltoid muscle is named due to its roughly triangular shape, because its shape resembles the Greek letter delta. Anatomically, the deltoid muscle consists of three sets of fibers, and these fibers are named according to their origin from different areas. So on the anterior aspect are these fibers, the clavicular fibers, which originate from the lateral third of the clavicle. And on the lateral aspect is this set of fibers, the acromial fibers, which originate from the acromion of the scapula. And towards the posterior side is this set of fibers, called the spinal or scapular fibers, which originate from the spine of the scapula. And these three sets of fibers then converge to form a single short tendon, which inserts over the deltoid tuberosity on the lateral aspect of the humerus. In terms of the nerve supply of the deltoid muscle, so this muscle is supplied by the axillary nerve. The axillary nerve arises from the posterior cord of the brachial plexus with C5 and C6 cervical nerve roots. In terms of the arterial or vascular supply of the deltoid muscle, so this muscle is supplied by the thoracoacromial artery through its deltoid and acromial branches. And the anterior and posterior circumflex humeral arteries. Some other arterial branches such as the subscapular artery and the deltoid branch of the profunda brachii artery also supply the deltoid muscle. All these arterial branches except the profunda brachii artery arise from the axillary artery. The profunda brachii artery arises from the brachial artery. The deltoid muscle performs a wide range of functions depending on whether the fibers contract independently or simultaneously. So as it's clear from their origin, the clavicular fibers flex the shoulder. And these fibers also produce medial rotation of the shoulder at the glenohumeral joint. The spinal or posterior fibers act on the glenohumeral joint, and these fibers extend and laterally rotate the shoulder, while the lateral or acromial fibers act on the glenohumeral joint, and these fibers abduct the shoulder at the glenohumeral joint. The second muscle of the scapular region is the supraspinatus muscle. So the supraspinatus is this relatively small muscle of the scapular region, and it is one of the four muscles that make up the rotator cuff. The supraspinatus lies deep to the insertion of the trapezius muscle, as you can see. So the supraspinatus muscle originates from the supraspinous fossa, which is this area on the superior aspect of the scapula, just above the spine of the scapula. After its origin from the supraspinous fossa, The supraspinatus muscle runs underneath the acromion of the scapula to insert on the greater tubercle of the humerus. There are three facets on the greater tubercle of the humerus, and the supraspinatus muscle inserts on the superior facet of the greater tubercle. The infraspinatus muscle inserts on the middle facet, while the teres minor inserts on the inferior facet of the greater tubercle. In terms of the nerve supply of the supraspinatus muscle, this muscle is supplied by the suprascapular nerve. The suprascapular nerve arises from the superior trunk of the brachial plexus, with C5 and C6 cervical nerve roots. After its origin, the suprascapular nerve runs inferolaterally and a bit posteriorly to pass through the suprascapular notch. And after passage through the suprascapular notch, the nerve reaches the supraspinous fossa, and here it gives off a branch to the supraspinatus muscle. And then it continues traveling a bit more inferolaterally to pass through this notch, the supraglenoid notch. And after passage through the supraglenoid notch, the nerve reaches the infraspinous fossa, where it gives off branches to the infraspinatus muscle. In terms of the arterial supply or the vascular supply of the supraspinatus muscle, so a large part of the arterial supply for this muscle is derived from this artery, the suprascapular artery. And a small part of the arterial supply for this muscle is derived from this artery, the dorsal scapular artery. Both of these arteries arise from the subclavian artery. Now, if we discuss a little about the actions or the movements produced by the supraspinatus muscle, so when this muscle acts in isolation, this muscle abducts the shoulder at the glenohumeral joint. What we discussed is the isolated action performed by the supraspinatus muscle. But the main action performed by the supraspinatus muscle is that this muscle works with the other rotator cuff muscles to provide dynamic stability to the shoulder joint. The third muscle of this region is the infraspinatus muscle. So the infraspinatus muscle originates from the infraspinous fossa of the scapula. The infraspinous fossa is this area on the lower posterior aspect of the scapula, just below the spine of the scapula. The infraspinatus muscle travels superolaterally to cross the lateral border of the scapula and moves around the posterior aspect of the proximal humerus to insert on the greater tubercle of the humerus. In terms of the actions, the infraspinatus is a very important muscle, because when this muscle acts in combination with other rotator cuff muscles, it provides dynamic stability to the shoulder joint during movements of this joint. But when this muscle acts in isolation, it acts on the posterior aspect of the proximal humerus, and this muscle laterally rotates the shoulder at the glenohumeral joint. In terms of the nerve supply, the infraspinatus muscle is supplied by the suprascapular nerve. In terms of the arterial supply, the infraspinatus muscle is supplied by two main arteries, the suprascapular artery and the circumflex scapular artery. The suprascapular artery arises from the thyrocervical trunk, and the thyrocervical trunk then arises from the subclavian artery. The circumflex scapular artery, as you can see, arises from the subscapular artery. And the subscapular artery then arises from the third part of the axillary artery. These two arteries, that is the suprascapular and the circumflex scapular arteries, then anastomose at the infraspinous fossa, as you can see. Moving on to the fourth muscle of this region, the teres minor muscle. So the teres minor originates from the lateral border of the scapula. Here the teres minor lies just below the infraspinatus muscle and just above its phalo muscle, the teres major. From its origin on the lateral border of the scapula, the teres minor travels superolaterally to insert on the greater tubercle of the humerus.
There are three facets on the greater tubercle of the humerus, and the teres minor inserts on the inferior facet of the greater tubercle. The teres minor muscle serves a very important role in terms of the actions it performs, because when this muscle works with other rotator cuff muscles, it provides dynamic stability to the shoulder joint during movements of this joint. But when this muscle acts in isolation, this muscle acts on the posterior aspect of the proximal humerus, and this muscle laterally rotates the shoulder at the glenohumeral joint. In terms of the nerve supply, the teres minor is supplied by the axillary nerve. In terms of the arterial supply, the teres minor muscle is supplied by two main arteries, the circumflex scapular artery and the posterior circumflex humeral artery. The circumflex scapular artery arises from the subscapular artery, and the subscapular artery then arises from the third part of the axillary artery, while the posterior circumflex humeral artery arises directly from the third part of the axillary artery. Now let's move on to the fifth muscle of this region, the teres major muscle. So the teres major muscle originates from the dorsal aspect of the inferior angle of the scapula. Here on the dorsal aspect of the scapula, the teres major lies just inferior to its fellow muscle, the teres minor, which originates from the lateral border of the scapula, as you can see. From its origin, the teres major muscle travels superolaterally and turns around the anterior aspect of the proximal humerus and inserts through a flat tendon onto the medial lip of the intertubercular groove of the humerus. The tendon of insertion of teres major muscle has a close relation with the insertion of the latissimus dorsi and pectoralis major muscle, because the latissimus dorsi inserts just lateral to the teres major muscle onto the floor of the intertubercular groove of humerus, while the pectoralis major muscle inserts further lateral to the latissimus dorsi onto the lateral lip of the intertubercular groove of the humerus. This arrangement of these three muscles can be remembered through a mnemonic, the lady between the two majors, where the lady referring to the latissimus dorsi and the two majors referring to the pectoralis major and teres major muscles. The teres major muscle performs a wide range of actions, and it performs these actions mainly by acting through its tendon of insertion onto the proximal humerus. So one of these actions is the shoulder adduction, in which it adducts the shoulder at the glenohumeral joint. And this muscle also medially rotates the arm in the same way, acting on the medial lip of the intertubercular groove of humerus. And one another action performed by the teres major muscle is the shoulder extension and hyperextension. And in this action, it acts synergistically with the latissimus dorsi muscle and extends the shoulder at the glenohumeral joint. In terms of the nerve supply, the teres major muscle is supplied by the lower subscapular nerve. The lower subscapular nerve originates from the posterior cord of the brachial plexus, with C5, C6 and C7 cervical nerve roots. Now if we study a little about the arterial supply of the teres major muscle, so two main arteries supply the teres major muscle. These arteries are the circumflex scapular artery and the posterior circumflex humeral artery. And the last muscle of the scapular region is the subscapularis muscle. So the subscapularis muscle originates from the subscapular fossa of the scapula. The subscapular fossa is this shallow area on the ventral aspect of the scapula. And after origin from the subscapular fossa, the fibers of the subscapularis muscle travel a bit superolaterally towards the humerus and insert here on the lesser tubercle of the humerus. The subscapularis is the only rotator cuff muscle that inserts on the lesser tubercle of the humerus. Because the other three rotator cuff muscles, as you can see, insert on the greater tubercle of the humerus. If we discuss the actions of the subscapularis muscle, so as a rotator cuff muscle, the subscapularis works with the other rotator cuff muscles in providing dynamic stability to the shoulder joint during movements of this joint. What we discussed is the action performed by the subscapularis when it acts with other rotator cuff muscles. But when this muscle acts in isolation, acting synergistically with the pectoralis major and teres major muscles, so then this muscle medially rotates the arm at the glenohumeral joint. In terms of the nerve supply, the subscapularis muscle is supplied by the upper and lower subscapular nerves. The upper subscapular nerve supplies the superior fibers, while the lower subscapular nerve supplies the inferior fibers of the subscapularis muscle. And these two nerves arise from the posterior cord of the brachial plexus. Now, if we discuss a little about the arterial supply of the subscapularis muscle, so to be very specific, this muscle is supplied by two arteries, the thoracodorsal artery and the circumflex scapular artery. These two arteries, that is the thoracodorsal and the circumflex scapular arteries, arise from the subscapular artery. And the subscapular artery then arises from the third part of the axillary artery. So this was a tutorial on the anatomy of the scapular region muscles. Hope you like this tutorial. Thank you so much.